Hi, my name is Franco Rotoli, and I'm a learning experience expert on the Solidworks training team. Today, I'm going to show you a time-saving tip for adding common or stock components into assemblies. Many times, we have components that we use over and over again in all of our assemblies, and we add the same mates to them. Using mate references, Solidworks can add the mates automatically, saving time and effort. Let's jump into Solidworks and see how they work. I have this manifold that's part of my design, and I have to add some fittings to the ports. In the File Explorer tab of my task pane, I have a folder of downloaded fittings from McMaster Car. These could be files from anywhere. I'll open one up and suppress the threads to get a better surface to mate to and for performance reasons. There are two mates I need for this part. Concentric for this face, and coincident here so it sits flush with the port. SolidWorks has a method for this. It's called the peg and hole SmartMate, but we'll save SmartMates for a separate video. The idea with mate references is the same. I want this circular edge to match up with a circular edge on another part. To add a mate reference, I'll click on the Reference Geometry dropdown and choose Mate Reference. For the primary reference entity, I'll choose the circular edge that I want to match up with the port. This edge does not have to be the same diameter as the hole. Because I picked an edge, default is the only mate type available. If I chose a face, there would be other options here. Also, if I want to always force it to be aligned or anti-aligned, I can choose it from this dropdown. I'll leave it as any for now. And that's it. Clicking the green checkbox completes the command. And now I have a mate references folder in the Feature Manager design tree. The reference I just created is under that folder. I'll save this document and go back to the assembly. Now, when I drag and drop this component from my design library over a circular edge, it will snap into place automatically. I've added mate references to some other standard components, and they all have mates automatically placed when I drag and drop them from the design library. I can even drag components onto other components, and mates get created. So no matter what your assemblies look like, if you have the same stock parts that are always mated the same way, consider using mate references to save time and clicks. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses. And as always, happy modeling.